Good morning. Good morning. My name is Carrie Wade, and I'm glad that you're with me here this morning. It's Sunday, and I just, my Connor here. This is Connor. You can see his nose, maybe? No, you can't. Sorry. As he jumps on my lap, you won't see him. But he doesn't like it when I do anything with my little singing bowls. So. Yeah, I know it hurts your ears. Okay, I get it. Okay, go back to bed. He's grumbling at me this morning. He's got to get the last word in always. So, how you doing this morning? Welcome and thank you for joining me. We're going to do a nice guided imagery this morning that is designed to help us get off of those tracks of negative thinking. Do you ever like start worrying about something and just keeps playing over and over and over in your mind? You can't seem to let it go and get it out of your system or turn those thoughts around and replace them with better, more positive thoughts? Maybe it's just me that does that, right? Sorry, I've got wet hair and it's like weird. I'm always messing with my hair. Sorry, guys. But anyway, this guided imagery is perfect for that. Sorry, I dropped something. Well, not important. Happy Sunday. I love Sunday mornings. I love Sunday mornings. Especially when I can kind of take my time. I don't have to be at class. None of that. So today is July 22nd. And I'd like to just start by saying, hello, my friend Robert. It was 13 years ago that Robert left his earthly body behind and transitioned. Robert was my best friend, and he was a force to be reckoned with. He was a wonderful, wonderful, wonderful human being, and I miss him every day, every day. And so today is kind of a special day for me. I like to reflect a little bit on my friendship and my connection with him. I like to sit in gratitude of all of the gifts that he gave me in this lifetime. And, you know, he was a huge catalyst for me in making major changes in my life years ago that, he taught me who I am, you know. He taught me who my authentic self is. And he taught me to love myself. And so anyway, I would just want to honor that and say thank you, Robert, for being here on this path with me. I wish you would have been here longer. Totally miss you every day. It was funny the other day, I was doing a Reiki session and I really felt Robert's presence in the room. And this client that I was doing Reiki with was also a friend of his. In fact, that's how I met her, I think. I think I met her through Robert. And I felt his presence, but he wasn't chattering like he usually does when he comes around. He was just simply holding space, and it was so beautiful. It was so sacred how he just was holding that space for us. But he did tell me during that, that he pointed out that I have no pictures of him in my Reiki room, and he wants a picture of him in there. Hi, Mark. Hi, Caroline. So anyway, I have to get a picture up there, and I think that today is probably the day that I'll need to do that. So anyway, it was kind of funny, but so just blessings on that. Okay, so are you someplace that you can take a moment and just quiet your mind and take a deep breath and just let your body begin to relax. Unwind. Whatever may have been going on for you this morning already, Just letting those things go now. Quieting the mind. Taking in a nice deep breath. And release it. Letting it all go. Another deep breath in. There's something that happens with that audible exhalation. For me, anyway. It feels like a deeper letting go. And you can do it however you choose to do it. Just imagine a beautiful white ball, a ball of light right above your head. And this ball of light begins to expand. And you are knowing that this ball of light is all about love and protection. This ball of light expands and begins to fill your body with its beautiful radiance, its beautiful light, starting at the crown of your head, expanding and filling your inside of your head and all around your head, clearing your aura and moving gently down, softly, slowly down your body, through your neck, your shoulders. Feel the light extending down through your arms and your fingertips, moving down your chest, through your ribs, inside and out of you, all the way down through your belly, your butt, your hips, your thighs, down your knees, all the way to the bottom of your legs, your ankles, your feet and your toes. And just continue to pay attention to your breath. Each relaxing breath is moving you closer and closer to your goal of becoming a stronger and healthier person. With each breath you take in, you are breathing in positive energy. And with each breath you release, you are beginning to let go of any unhealthy habitual habits. In the past, you have traveled in a world where you choose to remove uncomfortable and negative thoughts and feelings with an unhealthy habit or behavior. Most likely the thoughts and feelings that you were attempting to escape caused you to believe that there was something wrong with you, that you were less than who you really are. And now you've decided that you want to travel in a different world. A world where you can become aware of who you truly are and who you may become without the baggage of the past. The secret is that it's easy to travel a different path because the greatest transportation system in the world is your train of thoughts. It can and will carry you wherever you direct it to go. Trains of thought have destinations that are sometimes obvious, as though scheduled on a railway timeline. Right now, your train of thought is carrying you on to destinations that you have consciously or unconsciously chosen in the past, are choosing now, and will choose or modify or change completely in the future. There is always initial thought that is like a locomotive. The locomotive always has other trains of thoughts waiting to link to it. Soon you have a long, long, long train of thought that runs continuously in circles inside of your mind. And these thoughts create conditions in your life leading in the past to undesirable destinations. In the past, there were many times your confused and clouded thoughts caused you to pull into many undesirable stations. In the past, the train of thought was likely filled with all kinds of negativity. You packed your bags for your life's journey and filled them with thoughts, feelings, memories of separation, fear, resentment, guilt, and self-doubt, hurt, and anger as you traveled on this track of negativity. It depleted your energy. You now recognize you've traveled on this old train far too long. On your journey, you've been met with derailments and delays. And occasionally, you may have attempted to get off this train of thought, only to find yourself buying another ticket and getting right back on board. Rarely have you enjoyed the journey, the destinations of the past have lost their appeal. And now you are really interested in a new destination. A new destination filled with new healthy possibilities. This new destination toward which you are headed now comes in to your awareness. To reach this new destination means that you have decided to change trains. Now, as you have decided to ride a new train, it's time to leave the old train behind. Imagine that as you prepare to change trains, you begin to examine the baggage you originally brought with you. As you begin to open up your bag, it's like you can go inside yourself and find all your unhealthy activities, beliefs, and functions that you've been carrying around with you. As you explore inside, you also find containers that carry those things you have been addicted to. Substances that have caused you to ride the wrong train of thought for a long time. The source of your unhealthy habits. Here in this moment, you have the opportunity to unpack all those things that have been weighing you down and now leave them behind. You are ready to board a new train. You are ready for a new start. And you want to travel lighter with only those things in your bag that serve you well. You realize you've come to a new place in your life, a place where new beginnings can happen. There's a new train of thought waiting for you. You may be surprised to find how many healthy, happy thoughts are waiting to join this engine to take you where you want to go. This new train of thought is on the right track. A train of thought filled with trust, love, joy, faith, forgiveness, praise, and thanksgiving. You begin to recognize this new train of thought, realizing it is headed for bright, joyous destinations, health, prosperity, happiness, fulfilling relationships, new energies, and freedom, new exciting destinations. As you begin to board this new train, you notice there is some baggage that is still sitting on the platform. You realize you are ready to leave the old baggage behind. That was then, this is now. You realize you are on a new train of thought, headed for a healthy and happy destination. You realize it is your privilege to change trains. There are always stations along the way, in your own mind, where you can make the switch in your train of thought. The process might be described in words like these. I realize I am on a train of thought that's headed for a destination where I desire to go. Anytime I find that I may have gotten on a negative train of thought, I will simply get off this train and board a train headed for a destination to my greater well-being. I am choosing only those trains of thoughts that guide me to the destination that is healthy for me. Now, as you acquaint yourself with the contents of your new train and the new bags that you brought with you, your new train of thought is much more attractive to you than the old one ever was. You are now underway to your new destination. The greatest transportation system in your world has the capacity to move you to the greatest destination of all, oneness with spirit, the power that can restore peace and sanity. Any lesser destination is only temporary. And the sooner you board the train, that brings you into an awareness of Spirit's ever-present help, the less likely you are to be on trains of thought that lead to undesirable destinations. It is so much easier than you ever imagined, because you chose to make a healthy and positive person your new reality. You are directing the locomotive and the train of thoughts it is guiding. You will find that leaving the negativity behind is easy. Instead of worrying and agitating about stopping your unhealthy habit, you choose to just put it behind you. Concentrate on the wonderful ride you will have on the track toward the rewards you so richly deserve. Now, with a deep breath, you're going to return to consciousness. You will gently integrate all of this information within the next few days, or any time it's beneficial for the highest good. With each number, you will become more aware. Number one, allow all feeling to begin to return to your body. Two, feel yourself awakening. Three, with each breath, you are feeling more aware. Four, feeling more alert and refresh. Five, eyes fully open now, realizing that you are now on a train of positive thought. Awake, refreshed, ready to start your day. Hi, Rhonda, how are you? Yeah? How was that for you guys? Sometimes we just get so mired in the muck. We just get so weighed down with all the crap going on around us. And we've got to learn to be able to stop that train on the track, right? You can stop it and get off. You don't have to keep riding that same train that seems to just go in a big circle, right? You're not going anywhere with it. You're just going in a circle. So, it's that awareness. Bring yourself to that awareness. Bring yourself back and know that you can change tracks at any time. You can change trains. You can leave the crap behind you. You know, that's one beautiful thing that I do a lot with coaching and hypnotherapy is that, you know, we're not working on the past. You know, that's something that you do with a psychologist or psychiatrist or counselor. We're working on going forward. We're working on where we are right now, today, and where we want to go tomorrow. And we let go of the past and move forward in that. So anyway, it's a really awesome thing. Also, I took my Karuna Reiki 1 yesterday. Part 2 is in 2 or 3 weeks. And, wow. It was an amazing experience. I was having crazy-ass visions and all kinds of really cool stuff. Weird sensations in my body. At one point when I was doing Reiki on my partner in the class, it's this finger, my left index finger was like, it felt like it was a zapper. It was like zzz. So crazy. I felt like ET, you know, and there were just some really cool experiences. So I'm really, really grateful to Lisa and Lance for teaching that class. And also for teaching the, you know, the William Rand, the way he teaches it. I think it was perfect. It was just a perfect day. So I'm really, really excited to really incorporate all the new symbols and the new teachings into my practice. Reiki is my big love, as you've heard me say before. And I'm also learning cranial sacral. And I had a client on Friday night, a friend of mine who's a client. And I've got a client this afternoon. I've got a couple more on Tuesday. And so those spots are filling up. I've offered it for $35 for the first 10 people that will let me practice on them so that I can get comfortable with it and really kind of hone my skill. I'm sitting here playing with my bobby pins. What are they? These clips I use on my hair. Sometimes I almost forget to take them out before I turn on the camera. It's lovely. I've driven to work with them in too. So, you know, it is what it is. So anyway, so I just feel really, really blessed for that. And thank you for being here today. And Robert, I'll get that picture of you up in my room because I don't want you to get mad at me. And I hope you guys have a great Sunday. Thank you for participating. I love you. Peace and blessings. We'll be back tomorrow morning with the, whoops, ding dong. Sorry, Connor. The 40-day Mind Fast Soul Feast by Michael Bernard Beckwith. And we're on, what are we on tomorrow? I don't even know what day tomorrow is. I'm going to have to check this out. Being Your Own Hero, we've done that. Accessibility, we've done that. No lupus. Okay, I think this is our day. Ah, day 19, yeah. Live from your first nature. Ooh, that sounds like it might be good. All of them have been really good, actually. So, tomorrow morning, 7:30-ish. Have a beautiful day and stay safe. Peace and blessings. I'll see you tomorrow.